What's up? Today it's 8:39 p.m. Today we're going to take a look at a video called Body Positive Tess Holliday on the Complexities of Her Eating Disorder. Simply put, Tess Holliday is a morbidly obese person who claims to be anorexic. Let's take a look at it.
Gorgeous, Tess. Thank you.
Model Tess Holliday, known for her bright red hair and body positivity.
Not before I go on, I want to say that I don't have a problem with anyone. I don't care if you're big, I don't care if you're small, I don't care if you're anything. As long as you ain't hurting nobody and you're minding your own business, that's fine by me.
She's amassed over 2 million followers on Instagram and major brand partnerships. But below the surface, Tess says she's been suffering with an eating disorder.
I wasn't taking care of myself in the way I needed.
Of course not.
I wasn't looking after my mental health in the ways that I should have.
You know what would help? Taking care of your physical health first.
I was always making sure that everyone else's cup was full and I wasn't filling my own. So I think that's how I went so long without really being able to address, you know, myself and my disordered eating.
The 35-year-old mother of two says her decades-long disordered eating caught up to her in the last year.
I would go all day without eating.
Really? You went all day without eating and you weigh 5 times as much as I do?
And I would chalk it up to, I'm busy, I'm this. But the thing is, I had hunger pain all day.
I don't know what a hunger pain is. Look, I've been extremely skinny. I used to weigh 50 kgs and I wasn't much shorter than I am right now. I have unknowingly been fasting throughout most of my days, even since I was a child. And I have never felt a pain of being hungry. What happens usually, in the beginning, you feel like you have an intense fever. Then you get extremely shaky and weak, essentially feel like you're dying. And then it goes away. This takes about 15 minutes to go away. And then you don't feel hungry anymore. That's the only type of pain I've experienced through being hungry. And you can get through it easily.
And I was sick all day. Oh, I'm busy. I'm a mom. I'm this. I'm working. I'll eat later. I'll eat later. But later never happened.
Are you entirely sure about that?
And then at nighttime, you know, usually when my kids were in bed and I could settle, I would eat one meal and then I would go to bed.
One meal. How big was that meal? I could sit all day and say the reason I was a little bitch skinny kid when I grew up was because I ate a ton, but I just didn't gain any weight. Bullshit. Okay, there's no such thing. It's calories in, calories out. As soon as I started eating the correct amount of calories, I gained 15 kilos. I thought I ate like a fat person when I was younger. I was like, dude, I eat fast food every day.
I'll have 2 number 9s.
And I'm so skinny. Yeah, no shit, because I ate one meal and that was it. The fuck? It was like 1,500 calories. That's not even enough to maintain weight.
Holliday sought help and now says she has a form of anorexia, a revelation that has received some support, as well as anger and skepticism.
I am plus size, but advocating for diversity and larger bodies. And
why would you advocate for larger bodies? It is actually unhealthy. If you get too big, you'll...
So I think for people hearing me say I'm anorexic was...
You're not anorexic. Looking at your body tells me everything I need to know, because it is physically impossible. You cannot break the laws of the universe. If you eat too many calories, you'll get huge. If you eat too little, you'll get skinny. That's how it is. It's not a social construct. It's nothing. It shouldn't even be political. This has got to be one of the dumbest lies I've ever heard. It's insulting to people who are actually anorexic. You claim to be anorexic when you're 10 times bigger than them? You.
For people hearing me say I'm anorexic was really jarring and hard and confusing. I've had a lot of messages from folks that are anorexic that are livid and angry because they feel like I'm lying.
How fucking shameless can you be?
What do you want to say to people who don't believe you, who are skeptical when you say you're anorexic?
To folks that don't believe me, you know, that I'm anorexic and that this is what I'm dealing with, it doesn't really matter. Because at the end of the day, this is my truth.
There is no such thing as my truth. There is no such thing as your truth. There is only the truth. In order for us humans to develop fat on our body, we need to eat enough calories so that our body has the resources to build that fucking fat. Otherwise, you could always claim that it's made out of thin air, but that is falls on a molecular level. You know what I mean?
If this resonates with you, if you need help, get help. If this helps you feel less alone, great. It's so much more powerful just to say, hey, I'm hurting.
But that smug fucking look on her face when she's saying this too, like, it, She knows that she's lying.
Tess having the willingness to speak out about her experience, acknowledging some of the backlash that she is receiving, is an indication of extraordinary bravery and an indication of, you know, her health and healing and some of her process.
I told the psychologist, well, I won't eat all day. You know, I'll maybe have like coffee or maybe I'll have, a handful of whatever's around me. And then at nighttime, I'll have my meal or snacks or whatever. So I thought that that meant that I was a binge eater. And the psychologist looked at me and said, you're anorexic. Yeah, I am a model, right? I am successful. I've been doing this for a long time. I've been talking about, you know, self-acceptance and loving yourself and fat acceptance for a long time. But I still deal with it. I still get people that make me feel like,
you know, these abnormal anorexic things, these things somehow don't affect people outside of America. I wonder why.
And that's okay, because unfortunately, it's going to take a long time to change society's ridiculous standards.
Ridiculous standards. Huh?
Eating disorders certainly do not occur for one simple reason. There are a million things that can go right for a person, and one thing goes wrong, and an eating disorder comes to fruition.
You want to feel better, so you eat. You want to feel better, so you play games. You want to feel better, so you smoke weed. So it is a pretty fucking simple reason. You want to feel better, that's why you eat. And depending on how fucked up your life has been, you're probably gonna eat more or less.
There's nothing but messaging that comes from the world that says the worst thing that can happen to you is you might live in a fat body.
Don't call it living in a fat body. Because living in a fat body, that kind of takes the person out of their actions. I don't live in a skinny body. I am skinny.
And so if everyone is efforting to be smaller, 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 smaller.
It's not about being smaller, smaller, smaller. It's about being a regular weight that is healthy.
And we know that that's just not possible for most people.
That is possible for most people. Well, I can tell you from personal experience, when I walk out the door, most people that I see are in pretty good shape.
You can't look at someone and tell whether or not they're healthy. You just can't.
You can look at someone and evaluate whether or not they are healthy, because your body doesn't lie, man. It can't turn you into a blob out of nothing. It needs the resources to do that. So how you look physically absolutely tells me how healthy you are.
I understand that people look at me and I don't fit what we have seen presented as the diagnosis for anorexia. But then for me, that tells me that there's a larger problem, which I've been actually saying for years, is that we have a lack of diversity and representation in the world.
There's more diversity and representation than ever. We're inventing new things. What the fuck is a neo pronoun? People want to be animals. People want to invent new genders. People want to pretend that being morbidly obese is healthy. We need to stop accepting shit. That's all I got for today. Like this video. Subscribe. I'll make another video soon. See ya.